Oh boy, the incel mobile. Now the cringe will come to you. Also, I just realized this is part of an Illuminati video. Hey Blair, hope you're doing well. Hello everybody, welcome back to another video for the day. Now we're diving right back into r/incel tears, the risky video that hopefully I want to do more. But beforehand, be sure to like the video, comment down below what you like about the video during the video, and afterwards consider subscribing to the channel. Alright, let's go. Donate Chad for messing around with all the women. If you were a Chad, you would do the same thing.
Yes, but I'm not Chad. I'm an incel. Therefore, I want the Chads slaughtered for taking my women. If you defend Chad messing around with the women that would be yours in a monogamous society, you are literally a chicken hold.
Okay, look, I don't know the full censoring on this. All I know is a bunch of these incel tiers usually get demonetized, and that's why a lot of the bigger YouTube channels don't do it. I'm honestly still baffled that this site actually exists, the whole incels.co thing, but you gotta admit, these are some nice view of the mountains.
Foy therapist lied to me, pretty sure. To cut it short, I actually talked with her about the height pill. I told her how chicks don't date guys shorter than her, and she lied to me twice. She said, I've seen many couples where the guy was shorter, and both times she said it, she quickly averted her eyes and looked up to the upper right. This is a typical trait of someone who is lying. Look it up. It's over, Void therapist forced to lie to their patients.
Or you know she might have seen a bug. Just because you're short does not give you an excuse to be angry all the time. Seriously, you look like a darn chihuahua all the time.
Rick, I need kitty. Please, just one crumb will do. I can't keep going anymore. My body is shutting down, becoming decrepit. I just need one sliver of kitty to quench my thirst. Frick, I hate women.
Of course it's Pepe. You know, that's one thing I never really understood about women, is that some people just downright hate them for existing, and others really just want to mess around with them more so than they would need water in the Sahara Desert. And they call this involuntary. No, dude, you're just dumb. I was surprised Carson wasn't posted here. He's 6'3" and she's like 5'3".
Look at the way she stares at his Chad chicken, true offing fuel, knowing this will never be me. Oh no, I'm so sad because I'm lonely. Hello, I said I'm lonely, somebody notice me.
So you're saying you won't date me because I've messed around before?
Yes. Well, God forbid they haven't come out of a stasis pod for your standards, okay? I'm sorry they've had more interesting things to do than be around you.
The cosplay of Milady is so random, XD. Boom, $500 into her PayPal account. You know, I'll have to say, she nailed the look.
I hate this Doomerette shot. Of course, when a meme gets big, the quirky girls must cosplay it to get more orbiters. Just another example of women inserting themselves into anything and everything.
That's weird. It's almost as if they can have interest in the same stuff as well. Should someone inform the incels on what exactly the hype train is?
On January 11th, I made a thread here coming out as trans Chad.
Hey, I remember that post. Let's make fun of it some more. This part honestly was in my last incel tears video, so go watch number 9 if you want to see this one.
I still haven't come out to my parents about it because they're very transphobic, but this was a big step up for me that took a lot of courage. What I didn't expect, however, was for IT incel tears of all people to mock me for it.
Again, I'm pretty certain this was in number 9. If you want to, pause the video, read this, or go to number 9 and watch that.
There was nothing hateful or misogynistic in that thread, and that was me coming out about something that has been affecting me since I was young. But incel tears still feels the need to mock me, as if suffering from dysphoria wasn't enough. Frick them!
You know what, I'm not even gonna say anything. Guys who are watching, rip them a new one in the comment section. Cause I'm pretty certain this whole thing in general is making a mockery of some really big issues.
This is Liam. He's the best friend ever. He spent $200 to take me out to eat.
Love him like a brother. Hashtag BFF. Oh my dude, I'm sorry for you, but you know, it ain't working for you.
I'm sorry, but this is stupid. This guy's being friend-zoned. Heck freaking no.
First of all, he chooses to spend $200 on a girl. That's his choice. He'll either have enough money to do so, and if not, that's just plain dumb. She is not obligated to be in a relationship with him just because he's spending money on her. The friend zone does not exist. It's still a thing made up for people that didn't make their intentions clear and now are stuck being friends. Oh boo-hoo.
I'm sorry, but you're dumb.
Oh, look, he wins this round of Spot the Incel.
Oh, please do explain why I'm being dumb.
The friend zone does exist, but it's just a euphemism. Bitter women like you have gotten angry about being shamed for it, so you are lashing out about it.
The friend zone is the equivalent to a girl being frick buddies by a guy with the hopes of having a real relationship eventually. The reason it's not a friend zone is friends don't treat each other that way. Do your female friends list you complaining all the time? Or do favors for you and pay for you? Frick no. Right? That's because nobody would tolerate the shot from just a friend. So why do women magically think male friends would treat them like that, when female friends wouldn't? The answer is that they're pretending or just in denial. So long as they're in denial, they won't have to feel guilty. Whenever someone does something for you, you basically owe them and you have to return the favor, right? That's the social contract everyone simply knows. However, in those friend zone type relationships, the girl never has any intentions of returning the favor. If you don't think women use men as favors all the time, you're absolutely delusional. It is the most common thing in life. Ask any man and see if he'll agree. She is not obligated to be in a relationship. No shot she's not. However, she is obviously pretending like there's a chance at a relationship and letting him think so she can continue to use him. The friend zone does not exist. It's a thing made up for people that didn't make their intentions clear and now are stuck in being friends. Okay, so this is just replies on stuff. LOL, friends don't pay for each other, or if they do, it's back and forth. There's no such thing as one party paying for a friend all the time, so stop pretending like women don't know. Also, before you got concerned and trying to attack me personally, yes, it did happen to me just once in my teen years, but I'm in my 30s now and it has never happened to me since, so I'm not bitter about it. How do I know you're bitter? Because you deny the existence of the friend zone? It's so freaking obvious it exists. You know, I can honestly say the whole thing about the friend zone existing or not is kind of a gray area, although I do know for a fact that some people do like having people around, they just don't like them in that way, but at the same time, they have some anxiety about letting them go and just not wanting to talk to them anymore, and it's honestly more or less not wanting to get rid of a good thing that you already have going. And it's people that don't understand this that lead to the whole friend zone rant post. And unfortunately, there are also people that take advantage of this, the whole using other people part, because they know for a fact this person has an interest in them, but they want to make sure that they can milk this for all they got, and that's unfortunately where people get the rants about being used and stuff, because unfortunately, sometimes being used actually happens. It's just when people think that they're simply being used and the other person had no intention of that whatsoever is what leads to these nice guy and incel posts. Reason why women ruin their bodies. I swear this website comes up so many times, I might as well just take them directly from the website. The reason why women take tattoos and piercing is because they can. The reason why women purposely get fat by eating cake and burgers is because they can. The reason why women take cosmetic surgeries to make themselves look unnatural is because they can. The reason why women shave their hair off and dye it unnaturally is because they can. Every single woman knows no matter how ugly they make themselves to be, Chad will still pump the nut in them. They know they can have their cake and eat it too, and they are showing us subhumans we can never make ourselves even uglier and we would still be privileged. Yeah, I see you trying to hide that Pepe, you can't hide it forever. So what you're saying is, piercings and tattoo, while being a form of art and expression, is ruining their bodies. I'm sorry, who are they trying to make their bodies ruined for? Who are they trying to change their appearance for? Oh, right, themselves. It's not really you. Look, just let somebody do themselves on tattoos, you don't need the commentary, it's not your body, not your deal. Employee of the Year. Today we had an Employee of the Year announcement from my company of 100 plus people. Guess who won? The nominees were A. The balding Filipino supervisor that puts in 70 plus hours a week and then helps during his time off. B. The 5'4 manlet that helps with every office, bringing snacks and is a super happy mood all the time. C. A random blonde foy with big tots in HR. D. A 7-foot dude that joined 4 years ago. If you guess D, you are correct. Our president is such a cluck, he is a 5'2 ethnic tall frog, I like you, but I have a hard time talking to you because my neck hurts, you're just too tall for me, haha. By the way, you're tall, haha, tall people problems. I'm leaving this company soon, frick this place. And good riddance, the company's honestly probably better off without you. And honestly, you never really gave a description on the tall guy's work ethic. Like seriously, he could have been an honest worker who's been a hard worker for those 4 years straight and hasn't gotten it since, so this would probably be a crowning moment for him. And more or less, you're probably just upset because your lazy work ethic probably didn't get you the reward. So in all honesty, you quitting after this is basically you taking out your own trash.
We are not a part of this degenerate society. We are pure. We are innocent. Just look at social media accounts, music videos, or whatever. Degeneration everywhere. And you know what? We are not a part of it. We are the side effect of this society, and it's not our personal fault. Why we stuck in inceldom, we all know the full truth.
It's cause your personality is ugly.
No one at the recording studio for the music video figured out,
oh, what do we need for the video that we're not lacking? Let's get some incels, they'd be perfect for the
the marketing team. Incel Tears thinks the internet forums are just like real life. They're so delusional, it's hilarious. And for one example of this, check out some of their obviously fake anecdotes. Here's some from a user who claims to be pre-med. I'm pretty sure I have an incel in my stats class. I'm 100% he is a men going the other way. He calls things beta and collect, compares height and wrist size with other guys, and talks about it a lot, has zero social skills, and a very high opinion of himself. He tries too hard, he's really loud, he's ableist, and he's afraid of not being straight. I'm sorry if I get, I just don't want to be censored. He's pure r/I'm very edgy material all day, every day. Additionally, he acts friendly around the other guys sometimes, but he's been a jerk to me ever since I had to correct one of his answers day one. People try to be nice to him, but he's super rude, especially to women. He wants to be a psychologist that does clinical practice, but utterly lacks the temperament. I really hope he grows up before it screws up his career. Okay, guys, show of hands, how many of you have been to college? Did you ever get this kind of intimate knowledge of any of the random students in your class? Even in the non-lecture hall classes, there is never anywhere near this level of socializing. More people barely talk to each other, and in all my years of college, I do not recall witnessing a single dispute in class. Everyone was cordial with each other from what they had, little did they speak. Maybe now that the SJWs have invaded, it can be different, but still. This user would have had to basically stalk to the incel to know this much about him. Ignore how unrealistic it is for anyone to behave this way in public to begin with. This sounds like someone's talking about an elementary school class, to be honest. That's the last time you would get the amount of social interaction with someone in a class to be able to go into that much detail about them. Yes, this is Intel Tier's idea of real life. It's based on their internet experiences. Perhaps this person is talking about an online course, which would just make this come full circle into hilarious. There's this guy on the Blackboard website who posts really rude comments to all of the girls who post on there. Hilarious to think about. Anyway, these IT clowns just cannot conceive of the fact that there's a difference between online and in-person interaction, and so they assume that those who aren't just virgins but incels, lol, act exactly the same way in person as they do online, or they think that your misogyny will leak out when you reply to their posts on the wire-free message board. Okay, so for some clarification, I kind of think that some of this is false, because everybody who's been in a college course, at least after so many classes, you have to run into at least one person who stands out among the entire crowd and in not a good way. Definitely, I've had that one class where the person just keeps on wanting to correct the teacher. There, I even had one kid in a class that I was in who thought that everybody was against him and everybody was trying to hunt him down or something like that. It was ridiculous. You honestly can't come off as stalkerish if the person sticks out more so than a sore thumb. But with that is going to have to be it for the video. If you had liked what you had seen, be sure to like the video, comment down below what you liked about the video, and afterwards consider subscribing and becoming part of the ever so amazing notification squad. I will be sure to see you guys in the next one. Thank you so much for watching, and bye bye.